spiritual growth. And you have those times in your closet, and you have these experiences that you can't even tell nobody. You can't really tell nobody that church people can't deal with it.
Yes.
And your sisters are judging you. Amen. Say amen.
Amen.
But these things,
go ahead.
These things happen when God is building your spirit.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And what I'm hearing clearly, sometimes the house gets too small for me. It has nothing to do with natural. It has to do with spirit. Nobody wants to leave their mom's house. Nobody wants to leave their daddy's house. But every now and then, you gotta go start to move.
That's it.
I'm getting ready to let y'all go. Now that comes back, because everybody's time to get ready to let y'all go. Let's stand. I love all of y'all. So I don't want you to find the person who you said to need to go back to. I need to get somebody else. Okay? Oh, thank you. My wife keeps reminding me. If anybody brought an offering and you didn't, and it wasn't a part of that which you did before I released you, I don't want you to leave here without releasing your seed, amen? So if you have an offering that wasn't a part of what my wife did, I want you to come and bring your offering now. Glory to God. Get the basket, just come and bring it. If you have an offering, you came with an offering to give, and you were not a part of it, or you were part of it, you don't want it to be your offering, I want to receive it. I'll receive it from you now. We'll wait for you because y'all know I have an offering. We don't beg, gentlemen, love. Somebody say amen. But we believe in giving. You don't beg, because if you want to be blessed, you'll give. You know? Wisdom tells you, amen. Give. So I'll wait for you. I'll wait for you, Mika. I'll wait for you. I'll wait for you. God took me from the place of sowing. Pastor Troy said I would bring a 50 cent seed to where I could write $20,000 check for a seed. Don't tell me what God can't do. Don't tell me what he can't do. Y'all didn't talk back to me. It started with 50 cents. I was on drugs, and when we were going to church, my wife would give me 50 cents to put in. Somebody say amen. Or she gave me that before I went to church. I'm going to save that for the next round. Y'all don't know the whole story. Y'all don't know what she meant for. She ain't got the money. You know, with somebody like me. Anybody else, because I'm going to release a blessing that I want you to bless. I feel good.
Am I the only one?
I feel really good. I feel like this whole thing. I feel that God put all these talks together, including the prophecies that we got from my wife, and also we got from Prophet Smith. It was all a part of things working together. And I feel like the breakthroughs happened. So what we want to do right now, I want you to find a person you can get in touch and ask. Listen, the only command is love. The thing that we lack is love. As a matter of fact, I'm a challenge. I want you to find a person you think you might be an alternate. If there is such a person, I want you to leave your seat right now. Go find them. Give them a hug and tell them you love them. And if there ain't no person, you're an alternate, find somebody to speak to you today. I want you to give them a good hug and say, I love you, love you, love you, love you, love you, love you. Come on, love the love of Christ. I love you, the love of Christ. I love you, the love of Christ. Tell Jesus in me. Love the Jesus in you. The Holy Spirit in me. Love the Holy Spirit in you. Glory to God. Come on. Just hug somebody. Hug. The Jesus in me. Love the Jesus in you. The Jesus in me. Love the Jesus in you. So happy. So this is the love. Jesus, love the Jesus, love the Jesus, love the Jesus.